Hi, in last video we have seen the types of the binary tree. Now we are going to see about the representation of the binary tree. There are two methods, one is array representation and another one is linked list representation. I have given one example. With this example we will be seeing how to represent this binary tree in array and how to represent this in linked list. To do array representation we have to take one dimensional array, okay. In one dimensional array we have to represent the binary tree by level, also we have to represent that level from left to right. So this example I have taken, for this example we have to represent this binary tree in single dimension array. So I have told two conditions, one is we have to represent it by level, so first level 0 level only A is there, I have represented A in 0th level, this is 0th level, this is first level. If you go to the first level, you have to go from left to right. So we have to take B because B is the first left element. So we are taking B, after that I am taking C. Next we are going to level 2, level 2 there is D, F, G, H. So D, F, G, H, then level 3, in level 3 there is I, J, after that F don't have any children, so we have to mention left and right subtrees as null. G don't have any children, G don't have left children, so left child, so we have to take this as null. Then it is having right child K, then H don't have any left child as well right child, so we have to take this null. After this if you check for I, there is no left child and there is no right child, that is for level 4 I am talking about. I don't have any child, so its left and right child is empty, so for that two children. Next similarly for J also don't have any children, so again two null node. Again K don't have any children, so again we have to do null. So in levels wherever the node don't have any children, there you have to give the null node. You have to write it by level in array. Also we have to mention from left to right. Next method is linked list representation of the binary tree. We are using doubly linked list to represent the binary tree. So in doubly linked list every node consists of three fields. First field will represent the storing of left child address, second field will storing the actual data, and third field is used for representing the right child address. So I will be showing you the structure. So left child address, actual data and right child address. This is the node structure of the double linked list. For the same diagram I have given, A is the actual node or root node which is storing the left and right child address of B and C. Again it is the doubly linked list which is storing the left and right child. D is also having two children, but I and J don't have any children, so there is no left child, there is no right child, so these address will be given as null. Similarly for the F child, also C is having left and right child, so G don't have any left subtree, so it is null. H don't have any left and right subtree, so both address fields are null. K don't have any left and right subtree, so both has been given as null. So in part 4 video, so in next video will be part 4, we will be seeing the application of the binary tree. If you have any doubt you can do comment. Thank you.